Well, just when you thought you've heard the whole story, Target 8 is uncovering more about the political shenanigans Democrat-turned-Republican Roy Schmidt tried to pull off. 24 Hour News 8's Joe LaFerge is at the live desk with these latest developments. Joe?
Marley, if you didn't think this whole election debacle that Schmidt was involved in didn't affect you, think again. This is a report put together by state police, paid for by taxpayers. We got it through the Freedom of Information Act, hundreds if not thousands of pages. For the first time, we hear from the young man Schmidt recruited to run against him, and the most definitive answer as to why Schmidt did it. Included in the reports, the texts from the ones between Schmidt and Speaker of the House Jace Bolger setting up the fake candidacy, to the messages between Schmidt's son Ryan and the then 22-year-old,
no comment,
found himself at the center of the controversy, Matt Mojack. But the reports do more than put the facts on paper. For the first time, we hear from Mojack.
I mean, do you feel like you've been taken advantage of?
Yeah, okay. I totally feel like I'm used. Yeah.
In an interview with state police investigators and Kent County Prosecutor William Forsythe, Mojack explains it all started with a text from Ryan Schmidt asking him if he wanted to make some money.
In the actual text message, it says, it's nothing illegal or anything you have to worry about getting in trouble for.
It would be as easy as just changing his residency on paper. Mojack was already preparing to move into his grandmother's house in the 76th District and apply to run. But then the political excrement hit the fan. Mojack received another text from Ryan Schmidt.
Basically, he said, you know, holy cow, did you see you were just on TV? And I was like, yeah, you know, like, kind of freaked me out.
He talked about the reporters who showed up at home and at work. Roy Schmidt tried convincing him to calm down. They talked about the cover-up, including political reporter Rick Albin's interview with Roy Schmidt after the controversy broke.
I don't know anything. I've never met him.
You know, I said I didn't know you on that first interview that he did. I said, I have no idea who Matt Mojack is. And I'm sitting at that almost laughing. I was like, I just saw him yesterday.
We also learned from the documents that 24 Hour News 8 interview was included in evidence collected by state police. Despite Ryan and Roy Schmidt's attempts to calm him down, even upping the original offer from $450 to $1,000, Mojack dropped out of the race. And in the course of the controversy, Mojack asked the question so many in West Michigan have been asking. Why would an entrenched politician, who would likely win the seat as a Republican just as easily if he'd stayed a Democrat, go through all of this? The answer came down to money.
He said, for basically fundraising reasons, because if I don't have somebody to run against, then I don't have my fundraisers, I won't have the money to, you know, pay people, I don't have the money for fundraising.
And from the he just got caught file, Kent County Clerk Mary Hollenrick was interviewed by the detective and the prosecutor. She told them at the time that planting a fake candidate is not illegal and that both parties have done this type of thing in the past. At the live desk, Joe LaFerge, 24 Hour News 8.
Joe, thank you. The fallout from the Schmidt affair has resulted in legislation to try to prevent such election manipulation. The State House passed a bill that would allow for the filing deadline to be extended if someone decided to drop out of a race or switch parties at the last minute. West Michigan Republican Dave Ajima says that he wants to make sure that a mess like this can't happen again.
It's going to make sure this doesn't happen again. So if somebody tries to pull this again, where they at the last minute get somebody else and they're going to drop out and I'm going to automatically win the election. This is going to give extra time for a person to file if they try to pull that. So we'll eliminate that possibility. That's all it does. I think it's a good thing. And it's something, quite frankly, I demanded and I asked for from the Speaker of the House right off the bat. I says, we need some corrective action here. I don't want to ever see this again. It just makes everybody look bad. So I think it was a good thing. And I think if we have more of these issues, we'll deal with them as they come and it won't happen again.
The Senate will have to take action on the bill before it would become law, and that will likely not happen anytime soon since the legislature is meeting only sporadically during the summer.